Okay, so I wanted to do a review on the SVS Ultra Towers. Now, I want to clear up a couple things because sometimes people, I don't know, they say some things, it kind of gets under my skin a little bit. And it's important to point out. I'm the first ever SVS affiliate. I approached them and said, hey, I like your products. I would like to be an affiliate. And they put together the program, and here we are today. I'm very grateful for that. I'm very appreciative. I'm very happy and excited about it because, you know, personally, I would love to have an audio store and stock products and have people come in and listen and just allow them to hear what quality bass is all about, what it does for their theater and things like that. I can't do that physically because I have fibromyalgia. It's just not an option for me. I have physical limitations that prevents me from doing something like that. Even something that seems as simple as having an online store is far too complicated for me to maintain. And so I do what I can to be involved with this and still do what I want to do. And so, you know, SVS, in making me their first affiliate, they've really allowed me to explore this topic and really get into it and really enjoy it. But I want to point out that having an SVS name is not a guaranteed pass. Just because SVS makes a product does not mean that it's something I will automatically recommend. And you know, I'm not saying SVS makes bad products that I wouldn't recommend. What I am saying is that, you know, for example, the SB2000, it's a very good quality sealed subwoofer. Problem is I don't tolerate sealed subwoofers very well. Some people have a sensitivity to sealed subwoofers, and truly, considering the channel I run, it's really unfortunate that I have that problem. So, you know, when you look at my list of subwoofers, those are all subwoofers that I would spend my own money on without question. So a sealed subwoofer isn't gonna make that list. Doesn't matter who makes it. It's just not something I would personally buy. I also happen to like the bottom end of a ported sub better. It has more of a, it's just more output under 40 hertz. So anyway, I wanted to put that context in because I'm not going to request a product from SVS if I don't think I'm going to like it. I don't want to just request something, have them spend the money on shipping and all that, just to put out a bad review. And you know, that's why I don't have the SB4000 or the SB16 Ultras. They're phenomenal subs. I'm not going to deny that. It's just not something that I know I'm going to be excited about. So. And the reason I point all of that out is because I had a hesitation when it came to the Ultra Towers. Now, you know, generally in the past, I would have said, well, it's better to put more money into the base rather than the towers because, you know, that was just my thoughts. I wasn't certain that the Ultra Towers would provide so much more that I would be willing to spend twice the money on them. Because that's the way I look at this channel, is would I personally take out my checkbook and say, yes, please take my money. I like this product. That's just the way I function. Maybe it's not the right way to function as far as being an audio reviewer, but that's the way I look at everything. I don't do a lot of soundbars on this channel because soundbars aren't something I'm interested in. However, I am kind of interested in looking more into headphones at some point down the road, and that's another topic altogether. But the Ultra Towers. You know, when I went from the Prime Towers to the Ultra bookshelves, there wasn't this massive difference to me that I was like, you know, oh, it's got to be one or the other. Really, when it came to those two speakers, I could go either way. They're both really good speakers. They're both, you know, relatively affordable for what you're getting. They're very good quality. They sound great. And I was afraid that I would get these Ultra Towers out and be kind of, you know, like, I don't know. I had a big question mark over the value. And so I finally decided, yeah, I want to check these out. I want to know for sure. And so they sent them out. They came out on a pallet. It's a big deal. These aren't small speakers. They're heavy. They weigh a lot. They're big. Their shape is a little bit different. They've got more of a trapezoidal footprint rather than a rectangular footprint. And, you know, their marketing behind it all was they have those shapes and everything because it reduces the bass cancellations within the room. So a couple of things that when I first saw them way back when, I did not quite understand. But you see these two drivers here, these six and a half inch drivers. Those are mid-range drivers, okay? They are not the bass woofers. The bass woofers are down at the bottom of the cabinet, both facing, they're opposed, okay? And they're not powered. These are passive speakers. So these are not powered subwoofers in the bottom like some brands. These are just powered strictly by your AVR. They're ported in the bottom. Everything's separated. These are very high quality speakers. And so when I first got them out, I plugged them in and I had them. I still had the room correction set up for the Ultra bookshelves. And when I plugged them in, you know, I noticed a bit of a different sound, but they seemed a little bit subdued. And so when I ran room correction again, I got a polarity error, which is normal. It's in the manuals for the Ultra Towers that you will get a polarity error. And it's normal. And it's, you know, just ignore it. As long as you've got positive to positive and negative to negative, it's fine. And so I ran room correction again. When I heard these, okay, from the prime satellite to the elevation, to the both centers and the prime towers and all of that, they all have a great sound signature. They can all mix well, I guess is my point. They all have a sound that is very much SVS. It's all consistent, right? So I wasn't expecting that big of a difference, which is why I had the value question mark there. What I found was that, you know, the mid-range is really good in these, better than the Ultra bookshelves, better than the Prime Towers. Not that those are bad, but you definitely notice an improvement. But you also notice an improvement in the bass. Now, when it comes to subwoofers, I can say, I like this subwoofer, I don't like that subwoofer, and I can point to a graph and I can say this is why. When it comes to speakers, it's more subjective, it's more personal. You can spend thousands and thousands of dollars on speakers, and I've had that, where I've heard speakers that are much more expensive and actually would have been upset if I had them sitting in my living room. I just didn't like the way they sounded. I've heard some very expensive speakers and would have preferred other speakers that were in the showroom that were, you know, more in the, you know, $500 to $3,000 price range that were preferred over these speakers that cost tens of thousands of dollars. So more money doesn't equate to a better sound or a sound that you will prefer more. So again, that was something that I was struggling with these. But honestly, I feel like an idiot. These things sound amazing. When you go from something like the Prime Tower or the Ultra bookshelf to these, do you notice where the money went? Is it obvious, the difference? And in my opinion, yes. My opinion, why didn't I do this sooner? And the thing is, you know, SVS has always been a very honest company in my eyes. They've always been very forthcoming about things, not only talking about the benefits, but also the drawbacks of their products. They're very straightforward. And so I shouldn't have doubted them on this stuff. But when it comes to these speakers, I talk about the distance hack in the bass hack series. And the distance hack is where reliably I've been able to add about 4 feet of distance to the subwoofer after room correction, and it improves the bass response in the room. With these speakers, that's not true. And part of that, and you see it in the polarity error, is that the timing between these speakers And these speakers down at the bottom that are facing the opposite direction is a little bit different. It does make a difference in the bass. It does add a lot to the whole experience. And keep in mind too, I'm not running an external power amplifier here. I am just running a regular AVR. This one happens to be a Marantz SR7012. Awesome amp. This is my Denon AVR X6200. You know, I'm not running external power, so I'm just running these speakers as small. I'm also running them at about a 90 hertz crossover, okay? So I don't have a ton of power going to the lower end. However, it still adds a measurable amount of bass to the room over the Prime Towers or the Ultra Bookshelves. I would say the Prime Towers produce a little bit better bass than the Ultra Bookshelves. But the thing is, these add a measurable difference to the bass in the room. And it's almost like my distance hack is baked into the Ultra Towers. So if someone were to take these and know nothing about the distance hack and plug them in, they're going to get better bass response in the room versus any other speaker in the SVS line. So in that regard, I am very pleased with the way these have performed. Again, I feel like an idiot for not having them sooner. I'm really happy with them. And that's not new. You can go across all kinds of other very positive SVS Ultra Tower reviews. The very few people say, oh, I don't like them. You know, usually the response is, wow. And it's the marketing is real. The trapezoidal shape, the way everything is opposed, the way that the back is sloped on these, you have to pull them out from the wall. So they're never going to be right up against the wall. So even that in its design and placement gives you a little bit better imaging. So some of the downsides I'll say about these is they're big, they're heavy, they take up space. You need to have the space for them. You have to have those considerations. But overall, I'm very happy with them. They collect a little bit of dust on the backside, which is something I just noticed today. They collect more dust on the backside because it's sloped. But would that stop me from buying these? No way. And it changes my recommendations. Would you, get this tower or this speaker? If you can make these happen, these are phenomenal. There's definitely something that are worth looking into and eventually getting, because I am, again, I am taken aback by them, and I feel like I really missed the boat for a number of years. I could have had these out here and I didn't, but I definitely don't doubt their value now, and I'm very impressed with the way they perform. So if you've been looking at the Ultra Towers and you're kind of wondering, is it something that's worthwhile, or is it just an expensive speaker? Will I experience high-end fatigue with them? Things like that. I am very sensitive to high-end fatigue. There are a lot of speakers that are very expensive that I listen to, and they're just a little too harsh, a little too forward, a little too much. I don't get that with these. I get a great amount of clarity. Those mid-range drivers are, I'm very impressed with the overall sound with them. I'm gushing at this point. I haven't gushed over an SVS product this much other than the PB16 Ultras. The PB16 Ultras, that's another video I need to do. That's the best bass I've ever heard. Amazing, really strong. But these, I had doubts. I'm being straight about that. I had doubts, I had my reservations, and it was all unfounded. There is nothing about these speakers that I'm hesitant about at this point. The only thing, again, you just need the space for them. If you don't have the space for them, the Prime Towers make a lot more sense. They're skinnier, they're more compact, and they're a great sounding speaker. And they benefit well from the distance hack. These, I do the distance hack, it makes it worse. If I add about a foot to these, they sound better. But beyond that, I'm losing bass, which is something, again, I haven't encountered with any other SVS speaker. Every other speaker that has a normal driver arrangement, the bass hack or the distance hack works. With these, only a foot versus 4 foot. So, and again, that's a measurable result that I had. So I can say that, you know, again, speakers are more of a subjective thing. There are people that, you know, prefer horns. There are people that prefer electrostats. There are people that, you know, must have beryllium tweeters. Whatever. None of it's wrong. It's not like bass. With subwoofers, I can say that, you know, this particular bass response in my ears is wrong. Shallow subwoofers, which is the majority of what's out there, I can point to that and say, look, see this graph? To me, that sounds shallow, that sounds weak, it sounds thin, it's not something I like, and I can pick those out a mile away. When it comes to speakers, it's all subjective, it's personal, it's about your emotion, it's about what you personally enjoy. It's less of a hard fact like it is for me when it comes to bass. For me, it's measurable. Either it digs down deep or it doesn't. Either it performs without bad noises or it's got bad noises. You know, it's more concrete for me. It's easier for me. When it comes to speakers, it's, you know, again, it's subjective. You can be right or wrong depending on just your personal taste and your personal flavors. There are people that are electrostat all the way. Electrostats are the only way to go. That's how you get good sound. That's cool. I haven't had that personal experience. I haven't found an electrostat that I'm excited and want to take home. I'm not saying they're wrong. I'm not dogging them. I'm not saying anything bad about them. So speaker reviews are a little harder for me. It's not so cut and dry. It's not so, you know, oh, this is for sure this and this is for sure that. I will say that the clarity is amazing. The clarity I'm really impressed. And when it comes to the bass response, even more so. The difference between the Ultra Towers and everything else within the SVS line is notable. It's hard to miss, let's put it that way. They really add a lot to the overall bass response and the overall sound of the room. So anyway, I meant to do this video a while back, but I couldn't quite get it where I wanted it to be. I couldn't quite have, I don't know, this is a weird one for me, but I've just been so impressed. And it's, again, I don't want to sound like, oh, it's SVS, so it's amazing. If these didn't sound good, I would not give them a positive review, okay? And I think the number of positive reviews that are already out there, I think support that. So I hope people don't think I'm just saying it because, of the support SVS has given me. Again, if I have a product that I'm not wild about, I'm not gonna tell you, hey, run out and go get these things. That's just, I want to be honest with my viewers and things like that. So that's why I gave you the full, you know, disclosure at the beginning, because I want to be very clear about it. But overall, my biggest mistake with these speakers is not requesting them years ago because they sound really good. And I think with that bears signaling the end of the video. So anyway, if you have these speakers and you like them, let me know. Let me know what you think about these, if you wondered about them, if you have questions about them, things like that. I'm happy to answer them. I've spent a lot of time with these before I decided to do this review, so it's not a rushed, hurried thing. I've been able to spend a lot of time with them. And my biggest, the biggest bummer about these is I cannot put them in the RP project. I've been trying to figure out if I can do that. I'd have to remove half of the entertainment center on the left side just to be able to fit them. And then I have a weight issue that I've got to deal with. So anyway, I wish I could do those. I wish I could do these in the RV project. At this point, that's a no-go. That said, I've got it sounding pretty good in there. So, but anyway, again, I appreciate you watching. I appreciate the subscriptions. Things are coming together with this channel, and I really appreciate that. It has everything to do with my viewers. So I appreciate you watching. I appreciate you, the comments, all of that. It's for me, it's been a really fun channel. And again, I always learn things from my viewers, and I don't know. Just, I have a lot of gratitude. So thank you so much. Again, if you are looking at getting these speakers, please follow my affiliate links down below. It makes a huge difference. Doing this RV project has been a very expensive endeavor. and the support is very much appreciated. So again, thanks so much for watching, and please subscribe. Come on, Bear. Good boy.